Ja. English shops in Germany, they're hard to come by. And today I talked to Nikolaus and I give you an overview into the actual real German job market as it presents itself today, to give you an idea of how many jobs are out there and how many jobs are available in English for you, for international professionals. And during the next hour, you can send me your keywords that you usually use for your job search, and I will use an industry standard database that scans nearly the complete German job market to find out how many jobs are available for your skill exactly in Germany at the moment. Hello, my name is Chris Piak. You might know me as the author of a little book called How to Win Jobs and Influence Germans. You can get it on Amazon. And you also know my newsletter on immigrantspirit.com. And in the next 60 minutes, 59 minutes that we still have, I will try to answer as many of your searches as possible so that you get a realistic idea about what your skills, your abilities are worth in the German job market. And if you can use the standard application process to find yourself a job, or maybe if you have to use different techniques to break through the glass ceiling here in Germany. I just sent out an invitation to my 25,000 subscribers for my newsletter at immigrantspirit.com. So we'll give them a moment to catch up with the rest of us. I can see right now there are over 20 people watching already. Before we really start, let me check if you can all hear me very well. You can write me in the live chat. Jordi Nelson writes, "Hi Chris, good afternoon." Tejas shares his master's in supply chain management. Sheet says, "Hi Chris." Hello to every one of you that you are coming. By the way, this weird setup that we have today, that's thanks to YouTube, because YouTube used to be really easy for webinars and conference calls and interviews. But one after the other, they removed one feature after the other. So now if I want to schedule a live event like I did with this one and be able to share my screen with you, I have to use an actual external camera to do that. So don't be surprised about the setup here. Would be great if you could just let me know in the live chat if you can hear me all right, if the microphone is adjusted correctly so that you can hear me very well, so that I can later focus on giving you the information that you want. Don't be shy. Feel free to write a sheet. Yes, can hear. Wonderful. Great. That's what I wanted to know. Then without much further ado, let me take you into this database that I use to analyze nearly the complete German job market, and we start to look at the jobs that you are interested in. This year, by the way, I don't know if you can see the domain name. That's my website, immigrantspirit.com. And if you feel like you would benefit from someone helping you open a few doors for you in Germany, help you better understand how the business culture here works and how you break into the German job market if you don't fit in, so to say, then go to immigrantspirit.com. I've been helping international professionals for 10 years now to find a job in Germany. A small number of them actually spoke German. Most of them speak English and they come from all over the world. And I'm sure I can help you too. But let's go where you want to go. So this is a job feed. That's a service provided by TextKernel, a company in the Netherlands. And what they're doing is they basically scan the complete German job market. They have a crawler that scans, I don't know, I think over 30,000 career websites at the moment, 25,000 at the moment. All the big job portals are there, Xing, LinkedIn, and so on. All big companies' websites are there, many, many other websites. And they scan all this website daily to filter out all the new job offers that they can find. And as you can see right now, if you eliminate duplicates, there's nearly 2.4 million job ads in Germany. So there's a huge demand for professionals out there, companies hiring quite a lot. And let me show you how this has developed over the year, because I think this might be quite interesting to see. So this, what you see now, is the year so far. So in this year, there were nearly 12 million job ads here in Germany that companies put out there to hire people. And if you look at the timesheet, you see that we are in a very, very good position right now, considering that Germany experienced a second wave of COVID. In the first wave of COVID here in March, the number of new job ads dropped dramatically by 60%. Now in the second wave, we are basically at the same level, even a little bit higher at the moment, than what is normal to all during the year. There's roughly 250,000 jobs in total, 260,000 jobs in total that are advertised again every single week. So there's very strong demand in the German job market. Let's narrow this down a little bit before we then come to your concrete professions. And please, so that we don't lose time, feel free to use the live chat to type in there the keywords that you want me to search. I will do one search for each participant. No? So think carefully what keywords you want me to search for you. And once I gave you the overview here, I will go right in there. So would be great if you already put your keyword in the live chat so I can go and search. If you want to narrow down results to a certain region or a city, or you want to narrow it down by having more specific keywords, you can do that. When it's a city or a state, just write the state or a city. If it's if you want to narrow down the exact keywords that I use, you can use commands in capital letters. There are three of them. OR is one. So software engineer or software developer. There's AND, software engineer and SAP. And there's NOT. So software engineer, not project lead, for example. No? Yeah. These are, of course, all the jobs that are in Germany available. This can be educated jobs, non-educated jobs. These are paid jobs and internships. So let's have a little bit a closer look to get a better idea how your the job market looks for you. So let's first of all narrow down the jobs to unlimited work contract, because that's a high chance that you filter out all the unpaid internships and this kind of stuff. And if you do that, then during the whole year, there were 8.7 million. So basically, the majority of all jobs are unlimited work contracts that's standard here in Germany, and therefore they're mostly also paid. And you see, that's still very strong, 180,000, 190,000, 180,000 throughout the last few weeks. And that fits very well to what we had during most of the year. So the job market is still very strong, even though we are in a second wave of COVID. You might be interested to see how this number, 8.7 million, that's all jobs in Germany, compares to the number of actual English jobs in Germany. Luckily, text kernel allows me now to filter this out. So before we had 8.7 million. Now, if you look only at the English language job offers, we are down to 455,000. 8,450,000. That's 5.7%. Meaning 94%, 95% of all the jobs in Germany are only advertised in English. And this 450,000, if you would look in the job description, many of them, they are in English, but somewhere there will be written fluent German required or native speaker German required. So this gives you an idea how difficult it is to enter the German job market if you don't already speak German fluently. But it is absolutely possible to do so. And I help my clients to do this for 10 years now, but not if you use the standard application process. Just sending your application will get you nowhere. Why? Because the 8 million companies that hire in Germany, they see the HR person will see you don't speak German in your CV and they stop reading immediately. You are out. Even though you might be able to do a great job in this company. And the 450,000 companies, 450,000 jobs, excuse me, that are expertized in English. Well, everyone who moves to Germany is applying for these jobs. And there is more than 1 million people moving to Germany every single year. And most of them are European Union citizens. They don't need a visa. They have a right to live and work here because they are fellow citizens de facto. And there is about 100,000 Germans who return home to Germany, just like I did a few years back. I lived in 5 countries for 10 years. And then in 2011, I moved back here to Germany. And the rest are international professionals who come from all over the world. And you compete with every single one of them. No? So that's why sometimes it's helpful to have someone on the inside, someone like me, who can guide you through the German business culture and shows you the way that you can use to get a job in Germany if you are not a standard ISO-normed German person with fluent German skills. Okay, I see it's maybe the camera can be a little bit more down. Oops, komm schon, put. So maybe that's a little bit better for you. Okay, English ones back to the normal one. Oh, by the way, let me give you this at least, because you might be interested to know which jobs are actually in demand in Germany right now. Let's go to only active job ads and go to insights. And we learn a few things. These are the top 10 jobs, English jobs, ads in Germany right now. No surprise, software developer, sales manager, account manager, web developer, business development manager, project lead, product manager, scientific employees, SAP consultants, and customer service personnel. Those are the professionals that are advertised in English the most in Germany. The good news is that the level of education that is usually required is not that high. A bachelor will usually do. Then master and dissertation. If you would look at the complete German job market, you would see that a huge number of the jobs that are advertised there don't need a university degree because we have something called Ausbildung here in Germany. So that's a little something, but now really let's get to your questions. Let me look into the chat. And I will try to go from up to see all the questions that you sent. So, Theas has a master in supply chain management. Well, let's try that, supply chain management. I have to sit a little bit weirdly here because my microphone is blocking my keyboard. So what we are looking for now is supply chain management. This is active job ads at the moment. And all over Germany, not only the English ones, but all of them. For supply chain management, there's 738 job ads out there right now. Let's have a look in which part of Germany you find them. So these are the actual jobs with supply chain management, supply chain manager, purchasing manager, supply chain analyst, logistic manager, a purchaser, SAP consultant, project lead, logistics, business analyst, business consultant. Usually a bachelor is enough to get one of these jobs. And here you see the regions in Germany where you can find most of the job. And you see Bavaria is really, really strong. Baden-Württemberg, already 60% of Bavaria. Nordrhein-Westfalen, 68%. Hessen, and Berlin, 76%. So for this profession, Bavaria is number one, Berlin number two, and Nordrhein-Westfalen, where I live, is the number three. Just out of curiosity, this is English job ads. That's good. Oh, that's very good. So there's 738 jobs in English for supply chain manager. So let's take English away and see how many results we get here. You see, 4,400. In the moment when you are fluent in German, the number of jobs that are out there for you basically increased by, five times. Now that's five times more. Great. Yeah, let's pick up the next one. So let's see. Vanessa Patino. IT or product manager or product management or telecommunications engineer. That's too many. I do one per person. So let's try first, because that's, of course, for many people interesting. First, project manager and then IT manager. Might be a little bit too wide, the search criteria, to get you the results that are really fitting for you. So my internet connection is a bit slow, as you can see today. So there's 8,700 jobs right now for a project manager. And again, let's look how many of them are in English. 4,000. That's really good. That's a really good result. Let's see where they are. But again, on the other side, you know, that's of course a very wide term, because project manager can mean literally anything. If you look at details, project leads, IT project lead, technical lead, software developer, project lead construction, project lead web and e-commerce, business analyst, project manager, project lead healthcare, and head of development. And just like before, most jobs are in Bavaria, Berlin, Nordrhein-Westfalen, Hessen, and then comes Baden-Württemberg. So there's a little bit different approach. So let's try IT manager. Oops, I went to the wrong place, that's why. So IT manager. And not English, but all of them. 1,550 jobs. That's a lot. That's all jobs, not only English. In details, IT manager, IT specialist, IT project lead, head of technical support, system administrator, SAP consultant, IT consultant, network administrator, software developer, and system integration engineer would be the closest approximation. And as you can see, for this profession, Nordrhein-Westfalen is the strongest place to go. And then Bavaria, Baden-Württemberg, and Berlin, surprisingly, only half as many as in the big three states here. That's interesting. Now let's change the number to English jobs. And from 1,500, you are down to 178 jobs with IT manager in all of Germany right now. And notice this is from the beginning of the year, job ads that are still active. So that's 20%, less than 20%. And this tells you a lot about how difficult it can be for you to get a job, and the countries to the states to concentrate on are Bavaria and North Rhine-Westphalia. North Rhine-Westphalia actually first, and then Bavaria, and Berlin only 9. Well, is that what you expected? How the English job market looks compared to the German job market? For some of you, maybe you feel a little light bulb go on now. And you see, I like, oh, no surprise that it's so hard for me to break into the German job market, even though you have an excellent education, even though you have excellent work experience. But if the number of companies who hire in English is so tiny, then you, of course, compete with hundreds of other people. If you want to find a way around that, if you want to really be the number one candidate, the only candidate that they seriously consider, I strongly recommend you take either a coaching session from me or take my expert's job offer, Miracle. You can find more information on how I can help you on my website, immigrantspirit.com. Over the years, I have helped over 100 international professionals find their first job in Germany, and I'm sure I can also help you. Okay, let's go on with more searches. You know, this setting here, how this camera is set up and so, not really my favorite, I must admit that. Okay, this is interesting. Jordi Nelson is a procurement professional and is looking a job head of procurement or director of procurement. Let's search procurement in general first. By the way, if you know the German title as well, you can also send that as well. Because obviously, if the majority of job ads is in German language, then the job title will also be in German or the profession. So there's all over Germany, okay, 5,000. So you said head of procurement. Let's see. There's 90 jobs with head of procurement in all over Germany. And they are mostly, in German word would be Einkaufsmanager, Einkaufsleiter, Einkäufer Einzelhandel, Einkäufer Sales Manager, COO, Production Process, Head of Production Process, Retail Manager, Head of Engineering and Hotel Manager, so very wide range. These are some of the companies that hire. ThyssenKrupp Procurement is a headhunter properly. Cathay, Bombardier, Sanofi, Aventis, Leica. You see already there's really a wide range of industries. And Baden-Württemberg is the place where you go if you want to go into procurement. And everywhere else, these are head of procurement jobs. No? And if you narrow this down to English jobs, this will be probably very, very limited. 43 positions all over Germany. Procurement people, that's a headhunter, Cathay, Sanofi, Leica, Hitachi, Seller Recruitment, another headhunter, Cathay, Amazon, Aircraft Trading, Acar. 3 jobs in Hessen, 3 jobs in Baden-Württemberg, 2 jobs in Sachsen, and that's already the majority. Let's look procurement in general in English. There are, of course, much more job opportunities, 3,000, even in English. And then suddenly Berlin is one of your top options. Berlin, Bavaria, and North Rhine-Westphalia. Okie dokie. So let me see what else comes from you. Bagaki, AML or sanction compliance. Okay, let's try that. If you know the German profession, German names or titles as well, feel free to add them because it will be giving you way more results. So this AML or sanction compliance, let's first look all jobs. 544 results, and they are mostly based some of the companies, and they are mostly based in Hessen, mostly. That's interesting. Financial results. Now let's switch the language to English. And from 544, we come down to 260. That's still a good result. It's about 40% or so. Way more than nothing. In English, Berlin 28, Hessen 20, Nordrhein-Westfalen already only 13, Bavaria only 10. So way, way less. Okay. Zip. Let's see what else you got. What else do you got? If you want to have a testimony of how good I am with technique, it took me to remember that I could simply increase the screen size for my notebook so I can better read your comments. I'm not a friend of technique, and technique is not my friend. Aja, laboratory technician, also labor assistant oder labor techniker. Let's see that. 259 jobs. And laboratory technician, that's all of Germany. Again, 230 jobs. Now let's narrow that down to English jobs, sorry, all over Germany. Bavaria is the place to be. And in English, 141 jobs. Bavaria, Baden-Württemberg, Berlin. But you see already, this is very few opportunities. Here are some of the companies: Takeda, Max Delbruck Zentrum, Helmholtz Association, LE, Evotech, CSA Group, Weiler Scott, Christus Health, AstraZeneca Antibody Alliance, and Advent Health. Schup. So, let's see who's next. Fisnik, Credit Controller or Account Receivable Position. Let's try credit. What's the controller? Okay. 43 jobs all in Germany. Let's add your second search criteria. Let me see if I can make this keyboard a bit more comfortable. So. What was it? Account receivable position. Account receivable. Okay. 66 position, and that's German. So that gives you a really, really good overview. That's not a lot. So you probably, in your case, you should consider which other professions, which other positions you could apply to that are closely related. Or it might simply be as simple as that you have to search for the German keyword. But everything with taxes is really difficult to get a job if you are not able to read the German law. So, okay, more stuff. Ravi, SAP ABAP developer. SAP ABAP. Mit P, ne? Let's try SAP ABAP first. 1,700 jobs. That's good. Really a lot of opportunities. And they are in Baden-Württemberg, in Bavaria, and in Northern Westfalen, in my home state. let's look at the English job ads that you can find. 144. For a whole year, that's not very much. With my clients, I have these two programs, the Expert Job Offer by Christmas program that's finishing right now, and the Expert Job Offer by Summer program that's starting basically 1st of February and runs till end of July. To be sure that you get a job, you have to be able to reach out to at least 100 managers, not Onion Plus, but 100 managers during the course of these programs. So 144 total opportunities, that's really low. And you see, I didn't even narrow it down to programmer or developer. I just wrote SAP ABAP. And that's in English. So my advice is to also look at German language opportunities. But let's give me feedback to you. So you're Baden-Württemberg, Bavaria, and that's it. Baden-Württemberg and Bavaria, that's where you should concentrate. Your search. Schwupp. That's so true, so we can get as many as possible. If you want to go really into detail in this database, and you would like me to not only find you an overview how many jobs there are, but actually download, say, the first 100 jobs that really fit your search criteria after we refined it, feel free to book my intensive job in the email that I have sent today. You will find a link where you can purchase it. If you haven't registered for my newsletter now, do it on immigrantspirit.com/newsletter. Tomorrow, I will send this video around together with a link where you can book my coaching sessions. You will go to a site like this. That's immigrantspirit.com/intensive job hunt coaching in one word. immigrantspirit.com/intensive job hunt coaching. And there you find a description of what we will do. And one of the things that we will do together is we will go into this database where we are right now, and we search that we really find all the fitting jobs for you with refining the research criteria. And then I download the first 100 results for you. So you'll go out of the coaching with a list of 100 job ads that are available right now where you can apply. That's something I offer only in this year. If you go to the website immigrantspirit.com/intensive job hunt coaching, here you find a calendar where you can choose a date and a time for this coaching session with me, and you can book it right there. And then there are 6 days left this year, and then I'm off till 1st of February and then come back from the vacation. So that's something you can do if you really want to get not only a general overview, but really the actual job ads. So, Ale schreibt Java Software Engineer. Okay. Let's see. 267 results. Let's try Java software, because I'm pretty sure maybe we try better developer. There's really a lot of demand for your profession. Very good. This is all in Germany, not limited by languages. And strongest is in my home state of North Rhine-Westphalia, as well as in Baden-Württemberg and Bayern, and surprisingly very little in Berlin. Now let's look at English job ads in this area. Schubs. There's 213, and they are mostly in Bavaria, Berlin, and then North Rhine-Westphalia. You see how different this is shared. Some of the companies: Source, InnoGame, Kühn und Nagel, GitHub, Testo, Reply, Immobilien Scout 24, Hapag-Lloyd, Aussicht 30, and about you. So if you would if you would be a coaching client of mine now, then what we would do is we would search around a little bit more until we have a really as good fitting results as possible. And then I would download this list here with direct links to the actual job ads for you, so that you then can click on them and go to the website where you found the job ad and filter all of them out and apply to them. So you would get a list of at least 100 fitting results for your job hunt in Germany. And this is all English already. Okie dokie, let's go to a few more. So, Maria Wagner, Business Process Consultant. Let's have a look. Let's try business process first to see if we... okay. There's only three with this combination. But let's try business process and consultant. Yes. You see? This is English already, 364 results. That's pretty good. And without English, it's but 911. So if you are limited to English, then it's basically 1/3 of the total market. But from 10 years of experience, I should warn you that the job ad is in English does not mean that you will be able to get a job if you are not fluent in German. I have spoken to so many consultancies over the years, even for jobs like SAP consultants, which are super in demand in Germany. As soon as you are not C1 level German, a lot of these consultancies reject you. And the argument that they always make is, yeah, you know, we speak English, but our clients, they are Mittelstand, and they don't speak English, and for them, you have to speak C1 level German, which, in my opinion, is total bullshit, because our Mittelstand earns this money from exports, so they all speak English pretty well. But this is something that that consultants don't bend on. So if you are in a position where you require to communicate a lot with outside clients, here in Germany, if you're only in English, that can be hard. That can be really tough. Personally, I don't believe that the argument they are giving is true, because I, for example, I have worked as a recruiter for big German companies, and some of my best salespeople, for example, didn't speak a single word of German. And as a matter of fact, at the time when they were working for me, lived in Sao Paulo, Brazil. And they still sold a lot of services. Why? They might not have spoken German, but they knew how to communicate. They knew how to figure out what the clients really need and then offer a solution that fitted just for the client. But in my experience, consultancies, they are not willing to really give in that point. So that might be a little bit tough. Sorry if I don't have better news for you here. So, Azar, mechanical engineer. Let's look for you, Azar. Mechanical engineer. Okay. 350 positions in Germany. Let's try mechanical engineer or Maschinenbau. Ingenieur, that would be the German equivalent. And we come still to 700 positions in all of Germany. Here are some of the companies, Hochschule, Eurojob sites, that's not even a headhunter, Walter Hanger International, Valeo, Freudenberg, Brooks, Pöyri, never heard of that, BHS corrugated and BGZ. And they are very strongly here in the south of Germany, in Bavaria and Baden-Württemberg. Let's also check for English. Maschinenbau engineers in German is one word. You see, that's my mistake. Let's check again. No big difference. Oh, no, sorry. Let's see. No. Ah, you see? Very good that I checked again. 1,500 jobs. If you replace mechanical engineer with Maschinenbau engineer in one word, of course, because it's German, then you get 1,500 results. But if you then limit to English again, then you have only 282 left. That's less than 20%. Let's see where they are. This is now all of Germans. Result is still the same. Bavaria, Baden-Württemberg, and North Rhine-Westphalia is a very strong place. Vivek schreibt, SAP BWIB. AI. Okay. 230 positions. That's all in Germany. Again, Bavaria, Baden-Württemberg, North Rhine-Westphalia are the strongest places. 230 is very, it's enough, but it's not the biggest number you can have. And look at that. That's English for SAP BWBI. 18 jobs that are advertised in English. And the companies are basically, you know, all of the companies now. TTP, Stada is three of them. Plaut AG, Phoenix Pharmahandel, Pertems, Döhler, Big and Axiom. And you go to the south of Germany. That's all for this. It's really little if you don't speak German. The thing is, you know, if you are able to do your job in German, in English, while you learn German, and you can explain this to an employer, then I can help you break into this much bigger market of German job ads. But the requirement is that you actually think you can do the job in English while you learn German, and you are able to explain to an employer in detail how you will do that. Good. Rashid is a general doctor. I'm sorry, I can't help with medical jobs because the legal requirements are super complicated. They're very high. So Sheet, business intelligence or ATL or data integration or data mapping. Wonderful. There's no one who knows how to use a database. That's very easy to do for me. Business intelligence. Or ETL or data integration or data mapping. Wonderful. This is Sheet. Yeah, you obviously know how to use a database. Let's have a look here. 9,900 results. That's for German language one. Let's limit this to English. Still 2,200. What I would do if you would be a coaching client of mine, I would advise you to narrow this list down so that you have maybe 200 results and then go from there, because the better fitting you are, then the more forgiving employers are for everything that makes you unusual, like not speaking German, for example. Some of the companies, no surprise, Amazon, Zalando, Axel Springer, SAP, Olam, Salesforce, Project Adventure, Olam Information Services, Hapag-Lloyd, and Delivery Hero. From these companies, I have interviewed Zalando, Axel Springer, and Delivery Hero for the Immigrant Spirit podcast. I regularly interview German employers who hire in English. about the jobs that they're offering to help you better understand how you can offer a unique advantage to these employers. Check them out. It's on immigrantspirit.com/podcast. And they're based in Berlin, 422, Bavaria, and North Rhine-Westphalia. There's lots of opportunities for you. You will do fine. So, how much time do we have? 50 minutes. Roy writes, junior product manager and fintech. Let's do that. Might be a bit too specific. No results. In English, let's try German. One moment. My advice is take the junior out. 106 jobs for product manager in fintech. So that's what I would be looking at. I would not limit myself to junior because many of these jobs are in young startups and they can usually not offer you a lot of money. So they offer you a title and therefore you never start as junior something. You already start as a manager. Huh? So doesn't mean that with your qualification, you couldn't apply there. So Berlin is the place to go. That's not a surprise for you. Companies to look at, SumUp, Lowell, GFKL Financial Services, N26, Magic Line, Lowell Digital, Weerspinks, Magic Line again, and Backfirst. Bakaki asked me, how can you get noticed by employers? When you don't, even when you speak German? Good question. Not possible to answer in this very short webinar. Check out my YouTube channel. I have a full webinar on this topic called Expats Career Advice by Chris Piak, where I explain exactly how you break through this whole obstacle of being one in a million. And how to do this again and again with every company that you are interested in. And there's a free video on YouTube. Just Google my name, Chris Piak, and you'll find it. Or go to my website, immigrantspirit.com, and there you'll find more advice. Or, very simply, you can read my book that's on Amazon, How to Win Jobs and Influence Germans. Good. So that was the quick advertising part. So, ach, Jutta, Cloud Engineer, DevOps. Okay, let's try that. Sorry. Cloud Engineer, let's try that first. 792 jobs in Germany. And they are based in North Rhine-Westphalia, Bavaria, Baden-Württemberg. Accenture, that's a headhunter, SAP, Capgemini, I think also a headhunter, if I'm not mistaken. Profi.com is a website, Reply, Bridging IT, Opitz, Adesso und Avato Bertelsmann, they're in Bielefeld. And if you limit the job ads to English now, 227. So that's a very narrow list of results, but you also have a really specific keyword, which is good. No? So I would feel confident that, for example, if you would be in my expert job offer by summer program, I would be very confident. But by summer, you have a job for sure. So. Mebin, Electrical Engineer, Substation Testing and Commissioning. Okay, let's try Electrical Engineer first. 460 jobs. Now it down. And very specific. You see, for substation testing, no results. Let's try commissioning. Nothing. So, okay, let's go back to electrical engineering in general. This is also inclusive German, Bavaria, Baden-Württemberg, Nordrhein-Westfalen. But now, just to give you an overview, try Elektroingenieur, the German word, and you go from a few hundred to 6,600. So basically, this is the actual job market in Germany that could be available for you if you would know how to reach out to employers who usually hire in German language and convince them that you can do your job in English as well. If you feel that you can actually do your job in English in a completely German language environment, and you can explain in detail to an employer how you will do that, then I would invite you to join my expert job offer by summer program, because this will take some time, but it will work. And the way how we make it work is by ignoring HR and ignoring the usual application process, and instead reaching out to the hiring manager directly, to your direct supervisor, and having a conversation with him or her about her or his actual needs. No? So instead of applying first, you first talk to the hiring manager, you find out what he actually needs, what he needs to achieve, and then you can prove with your experience how you will solve this very specific problem. And that makes you the top candidate. That's a tip for all of you. If you're in any way unusual, then talking in unspecific terms is always your enemy. It's like fighting fog, no? Like when you apply for a job and they say, yeah, do you speak German? No? If you try to prove to them that you will be able to speak German and learn German and so on, that will not convince someone, because it's like trying to fist bump a fog and to beat fog. It's impossible. And that's because the person who asks you at that point doesn't really have a clear understanding why you would need German either. No? It's just an assumption that they have. And it's impossible to convince them otherwise, because they don't know really what their concern is. So what you have to do in this moment is you have to make it as specific as possible. No? You have to ask him, hey, what is it that you actually try to achieve here? What is the most important outcome? And then you talk about language, not in general terms, no? But in terms of this concrete outcome that they try to achieve. And then when you can prove that you can achieve this outcome, even when you speak English, then you're halfway there. No? So as a rule of thumb, when you come into a difficult situation where you feel like a job is slipping away from you because of language skills, the thing to do is always to take the conversation from general to very concrete and specific, and talk about that and how we can solve that. But for that, you actually have to have a conversation with the manager first. And that's not something you achieve by sending your application over and over. They just get rejected. HR people in Germany look 7 to 12 seconds on a CV. And when the first thing that they see about you is, how, you don't speak German, they reject you without even reading any further. That's why services like mine are necessary. And that's why I'm on the other side so successful, because we ignore HR. We talk directly to the manager. So we have time for what? A few more. David Nadarski, hi. Adidas Puma, well, yes, there's lots of jobs at Adidas Puma. Need to be a little bit more specific. What is the job you're interested in? Then I can search it for you. Walter Josef, auditor, accountant. Without looking, I can tell you there's lots of jobs for Buchhalter and for auditors. My question is, how will you do this without understanding German law, without being able to read German law? Can you explain that? If you can explain that, then it makes sense to make the search. If not, then maybe you need to shift your focus into related fields. So, Bhupesh, software QA engineer. My nose is itching. There's 174 jobs for software QA. Let's try. A bit wider. Okay, that's that's too far. That's still too far. And engineer 1218 jobs with keyword quality assurance and software and engineer. And as you can see, a software developer, quality assurance engineer, 157 jobs, software tester, DevOps engineer, qualitätsmanager, web entwickler, system engineer, quality engineer, engineer, and Java developer. And also for this job, only bachelor is fine. And they are mostly based in Baden-Württemberg, in Bavaria, North Rhine-Westphalia, and Berlin, obviously. SAP, Immowelt, DNV, Robert Bosch, Amazon, Axel Springer, Secunet, Zypeople, and Auto1 are some of the biggest employers in this field. So. So, Dina Bandu, IT Backup Administrator, EMC Networker. Oh, now come the really technical jobs here, huh? Let's go. IT backup. Admin. And ich mach mal, I write OA. EMC. Okay. See? 38 jobs. That's very specific, but it's also super fast over. Companies, Fujitsu, MyToys. We actually have an interview with the head of IT for MyToys on our website. If you go to immigrantspirit.com/podcast, I interviewed him last year, I think. No, somewhere during this year, I interviewed him. Really nice people, really nice guys from England. And they want to hire English. No, so English will not be a problem there. New Yorker, Müller Medien, Johannes Bernberg, Goslar, Fujitsu, Einkaufsbüro Deutsche Eisenbahngesellschaften und 1&1 Internet. Mostly in Hessen and Baden-Württemberg. Very few results and very specific. Okay, so to be sure, I would try to widen, in your case, actually widen the search a little bit to get more. Ah, David Nadarski, Supply Chain at Adidas. And see, Adidas and Puma, they are a little bit specific as a company because there's a lot of companies in Germany that actually pay their employees if they can find new people that they can bring on board. Adidas is the opposite. They have a very strict anti-nepotism rule. So in Adidas, you only can apply. There's literally no other way. You cannot go to a manager or ask a friend to make a recommendation that doesn't work. You can only apply to the standard levels. We did an interview with Adidas 3-4 years ago. So Adidas, of course, has jobs to offer, 12 jobs to be precise. But there are still very, very wide field. So we would have to narrow down these results, I think. So, jobs for data science, I see here. That's a good example. It's very high in demand, and a lot of my clients also come from this field. There's lots of jobs in data science, really a lot of jobs. It's the future. It's one of the really strong growing professions. And even if you narrow down the search to English, there's still 1,740 positions out there. And look at where they are. So there's data scientist, information engineer, machine learning engineer, software developer, data manager, product manager, scientific employee, business analyst, IT specialist, software developer, data modeling. Here you can see the number of jobs that require a little bit higher degree, like master or even a PhD, is higher than, it's roughly half of all the job positions. And strongest field is, of course, Berlin, Bavaria, Nordrhein-Westfalen, and Hessen. Some of the companies, Zalando, we had an interview with them as well, BASF, Amazon, Delivery Hero, and Bayer are some of the strongest employers in this field. But by far not the only one. There's lots of other employers. Actually, let's check this out. This is the top 10 of employers. But how many employers, if we go to direct employers, I can search this here. How many employers are there all over Germany that hire someone with experience as a data scientist? So in all of Germany, there's 800 companies, a little bit less than 800 companies that hire data scientists. So there's a good number for you. And yeah, go at it. Time is up. I'm very sorry. Couldn't get through all of you. You were so many requests from you. If you would like to have a little bit more time and talk about your career in Germany with me in a one-on-one coaching session via Zoom and get some strategies that can help you go past HR and get in touch directly with the hiring manager so you can have a really meaningful conversation about job openings and also go into this database together with me and filter out the really fitting job offers for you and download maybe 100 job ads that are currently available for you, feel free go to immigrantspirit.com/intensive job hunt coaching. That's immigrantspirit.com/intensive job hunt coaching. And you can book an appointment with me there. I will repeat the website one more time. After I showed you here. If you go to the website, that's how the website looks, by the way. Here's a video of mine. Here's the number of days that vacation, and I will be back only by 1st of February. So this year, there's basically only 6 days left where you can have a coaching session. That would be either next Wednesday, next Thursday, or the week afterwards, Monday, Wednesday, Thursday. In the Christmas week, I have 2 more appointments. There's 6 appointment days available. Here's the website, immigrantspirit.com/intensive job hunt coaching. Tomorrow, I also send out a newsletter with a little reminder and the link to the website so that you can find it. My name is Chris Gack. I'm the author of How to Win Jobs and Influence Germans, the guide to your first job in Germany. I do this for about 10 years now. And have helped over 100 international professionals like you to find a job here in Germany. I would be glad to help you as well. I hope this was useful for you, and I all wish you a very wonderful Nikolaus Day or what is left of it. Bye-bye. So, this is how it looks on the backside, by the way.